This is my sexy joker look. I didn't have a purple coat, so I kind of opt for a green one. If you have a purple coat, a purple like shirt, or like, I don't know, one of those suit thingies, feel free to wear that. Change up the look however you like. This is my sexy female joker look. Hopefully you guys do enjoy it. If you do, don't forget to like this video, subscribe, check out smashingbeauty.com for all the details. Don't forget to follow me on one of my social media sites. All the links are below the video in the info box. And now let's get down to the tutorial. Hi everyone, so first we're going to start with the Rick Collodin from Maron, and I'm going to be applying it at this part of my face. Remember, never apply this anywhere. If you can feel your bone right here, your like cheekbone, never apply it anywhere above your cheekbone around your eyes, so avoid this area right here when using this, and never use it like more than 2 days in a row in the same spot. It actually can result in actual scarring. That's how strong this is. So if you have sensitive skin, maybe you should ask your dermatologist about this. So just do keep that in mind. So we're gonna make a smile and apply it to clean skin. Right there. So we apply it and then we wait. Oh my god, you can actually feel my skin changing. I want it to be more open down here, so I'm gonna apply more. So I'm applying a few layers just so my skin really, you know, like gets a really visible scarring. So now I'm going to be taking my white foundation from RCMA and my Cinema Secrets foundation, and I'm going to be mixing up the two to get a very pale pink hued foundation. You want it to be more white than skin color and something like that. You see, you can barely pick up on the skin color, but it is there. So, or you can go pure white. Now that that is done, we're going to be doing the eyebrows. And what you want to do is you want to make really arched eyebrows and really dark defined eyebrows. We're going to kind of like do more aged look eyebrows. And I'm going to, you can leave them your own color, or if you want, you can like make them green, but I'm going to do my own color. I'm going to be taking the darkest eyebrow pencil I have. It's called Top Shelf. It's Sigma Beauty. There we go. We're going to be using the purple eyeshadow from the Creative Me palette from Coastal Scents. And I'm going to be using my Sigma Beauty E55 brush and applying it on my eyelid. I'm going to be picking up my green eyeshadow, the Prehistorical Green, and my Vibrant Green. So these two greens I'm going to be picking up and applying it into my crease and blending it up a little bit more. I'm taking a white eyeshadow and applying with E55 on my below eyebrow area. Take the pencil brush from Sigma, the E30, and Makeup Geek's Corrupt Eyeshadow and applying it into the crease. I'm going to be taking Inglot's Green Eyeshadow. I'm sorry, I don't know which number this is. I'm going to be applying it on my lower eyelid. Crazy pigmented, look at that. I'm going to be taking a smaller brush, the E46, which is for the inner corner. It's a small sturdy brush, and I'm going to be picking up Sigma's Corrupt and applying it on my lower eyelid and blending it into the green, connecting it with the top. And then then I'm going to take the small crease brush E47. It's from the Performance Kit, and just blending this up. Blending the black into the green. I'm going to be taking a black coal liner and applying it, actually Kajal liner, and applying it on my waterline. Now pick up a pink blush with a dual fiber brush. And why dual fiber? Just because it's going to apply less product on the skin. And with a very light hand, apply it onto your cheek, like right there. And just blend it out. You want it to be like a light coat. Opposite eye, since I'm like making a little more modern version, I'm going to be taking my black eyeliner pencil and applying it on my eyelid like this. Nothing too neat, and my lower lid like this. Then I'm taking my concealer brush in F70 and spreading this all out. Eye shading brush in E55, my Makeup Geek black eyeshadow in Corrupt, and tapping it on my eyelid. We're going to be setting it like this. You can see I smudged it a little bit, so it's not really neat. I'm going to be taking my inner corner brush in E46, and I'm going to be applying the details. And now, just to even this out a little bit, I'm just gonna apply a little bit, you know, like that clown line right there, like that. It does not have to be messy, neat, I'm sorry. It's not a neat clown look, so. Now we're gonna do the lips. You make them big and round. I'm going to be taking my MUA Lip Liqueur in Atomic and applying on my lips. And I'm going to be using my Sigma lip brush in L05. I'm going to be taking my Essence eyeliner. It has to be waterproof eyeliner. And I'm going to be applying it in the middle of the scar. I'm going to be it's hard to explain right now, but you're going to see it. I just want that the inner part of this scar is black, so I do recommend using a waterproof liner. Now we're going to be taking Thick Blood, like that, from Bed Nye, and I'm going to be taking any, this is my art painting brush, and you're going to be taking any fake blood, whatever you want. Now take the Thick Blood, apply it into the scarring over the black you just applied. Apply a little bit more like that. So now we established the thick part, and now we're gonna take the fake blood. I'm gonna be taking some out and putting it in the back of my hand, and then applying it. You want it to also run in some places. To make this look a little bit more fun, I'm going to be applying on this eye right there, very dramatic lashes. You don't need to apply any lashes here just because it's very black and you really won't see them. But here, I think it's great to apply very dramatic lashes, and then I'll be back. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this, don't forget to check out the other tutorials. You can see the pictures below. Just click on it, I'll be redirected. For all the information, please check out to smashingbeauty.com. Subscribe to my Instagram account. follow me on my Facebook and Twitter if you have any shout outs, or if you recreate one of these looks, please hashtag me at #smashingbeauty and tag me. You can see right here one of my social media sites. I would love to see your looks if you recreate any of these looks and reshare it on one of my social media sites. Thank you guys so much for watching, and don't forget to like, share this if you enjoyed it, and that's that. See you Friday. Bye.